In the history of Smash, Europe has always been the middle child. Japan and the US get most of the attention and simply have larger and more frequent events. But don't just take my word for it, take a look at the numbers. Actually, wait, before you look at those numbers, take a look at ProGuides.com. We've got tons of stuff on there that you might like, including live coaching sessions, character guides, and lessons from some of the best players in the world. Albion 4, one of Europe's biggest tournaments, reached 895 entrants. The Umabura Japan Major capped out at 1,015 entrants, and Evo Japan reached 2,988 entrants. But don't get too excited for Japan. Since it was a free event, a lot of people registered and didn't show up, meaning the real entry number was closer to 1,800. Still, Japan's got a bigger pool of competitive Smashers than Europe, and that's saying something because the European Union has nearly 5 times the population of Japan. And then there's the US. In the US, Super Smash Con had over 2,700 entrants, and Evo had nearly 3,500 entrants. There's kind of no question that the US is the biggest region in Smash and one of its epicenters. If you're familiar with the wider world of esports, you might know that Japan and the US traditionally excel at console games, while Europe excels at PC games. Just go into any CSGO stream with an NA team in it, and you'll see a lot of Europeans smack-talking NA. And the Europeans have kind of earned that smack-talk. European teams outperform NA at pretty much every big computer game, whether it's Dota 2, League of Legends, or CSGO. And Europeans don't even bother to smack talk Japan because Japan's so irrelevant to PC gaming that it's not worth the banter. Sorry, Japan. But hey, you're still totally sick at fighting games. Anyways, Europe isn't the biggest region, but they're far from bad at Smash. In almost every Smash iteration, Europe has produced a top 10 caliber player. In Melee, Europe produced one of, if not the best player of all time, Armada. In Brawl and Smash 4, it was Mr. R, and now in Ultimate, it's Gluttony, who just got ranked 8th on the PGR. And likewise, NA tends to produce a handful of top competitors in League, Dota, and CSGO. In each of these three esports, North America has one or two good teams that can easily beat the Tier 2 regions while making the Tier 1 regions sweat. So, are we underrating EU in Smash and NA in PC games? Kind of. The real problem is that we're just not talking about depth. In sports, depth is one of the trickiest things to capture. It's actually pretty easy to spot a top 10 caliber player if you know the game well. They're just more consistently great than other players. Measuring the strength of the top 50 or the top 100 players is trickier, and there's a few reasons for that. The first is available data. In basketball, a top 10 player is getting a ton of usage. That means they're playing 30 to 40 minutes in most games, and they're taking a lot of shots. Meanwhile, a top 100 basketball player might only get 20 minutes and not touch the ball very often. That means star players can sometimes have nearly double the data that a bench or role player has. And the same logic applies even more so to Smash. In Smash, we have an insane amount of data on top players because they have sponsors that fly them out to events. On top of that, top players don't often get eliminated early, so they play a lot more sets against a lot more players. For example, if you got 33rd place at Albion, you played approximately 6 sets total, winning 4 and losing 2. If you got to Grand Finals, you had to play 10 or more sets. You can see this effect play out in the rankings too. Smash has several different rankings, PGR, Orion Rank, StatSmash, and more. But the top 10 or so of all of these rankings looks pretty similar. Meanwhile, 50 through 41 looks pretty different in each one. So what's all this got to do with Europe? Well, the problem with Europe is all about depth and how difficult it is to measure. It's super obvious that Gluttony is good. Like, really good. If you look at Gluttony's results, the worst he's ever placed in Ultimate is 17th. And outside of those two placements, he's not just consistently top 8, he's consistently top 4. Rating Gluttony isn't hard. He's either in your top 10, or you hate Wario or something. The real problem is rating competitors like Quick, Space, and Meru. These guys are clearly good, but they don't get to travel as much as Gluttony, so it's hard to tell just how good they are. It's not that their results in Europe don't matter, it's just that most European tournaments don't have the same level of competition. Not only does Europe have less Smash players, they also don't have as many top competitors to measure against. Gluttony is the only top 10 player in Europe, and he pretty much torches the competition in Europe. In terms of set counts, Gluttony is up 10-3 on Quick, 11-3 on Space, 15-3 on Meru, 3-0 on Mr. R, and 1-0 on Leffen. That's MKLeo levels of dominance. When the top competitors come to Europe, they tend to torch the competition too. DeBuzz tore through the bracket at Albion 4, and only lost to Raito and Gluttony. MKLeo has gone over to Europe and won a few times. For comparison, the one time MKLeo didn't get top 8 was in Japan. If you're looking at the results honestly, it's kinda clear that Europe just doesn't have the same depth as Japan or the US. So it's not underrating Europe to call it the third best region underneath the US and Japan, but is it underrating Europe to not put players like Quick or Space in the top 50? The truth is, there's an argument for both sides here. The argument against Europe is that the top 40 through 50 in the PGR are insanely talented and have taken games off of really strong competitors. Sometimes even the top 10. Even Ron, the Japanese Yoshi who got ranked 50th and won a lifetime supply of memes, has beaten Ken, T, and Proto Banham. To put that in perspective, Quick got 3-0'd by T and 2-0'd by Ken. So you better put some respect on Ron's name! When you ask if Quick is top 50 in the world, it's pretty easy to think about how good Quick Samus is. Then to think about how he smacks down every European player not named Gluttony. And then to say, oh, hell yeah, Quick is top 50. But when you ask if Quick is better than Ron, Big D, Kirihara, Riddles, Cola, Arfang, Mr. R, Bestness, Goblin, Hikaru, and Scat, it's a lot harder to say hell yeah, and a lot easier to say, geez, okay, let me pull open smashdata.gg and we'll get back to you in an hour. It's also worth noting that the PGR isn't really ranking players by their current skill, it's actually ranking them by how good a season they had overall. Most players will say that Quick is better than Mr. R right now, since Quick has a 4-1 set count against Mr. R and has been doing better in Europe. But the PGR puts Mr. R above Quick because Mr. R actually popped off at a few big international tournaments, most notable Evo, where he beat Nairo and got 13th. When you look at the PGR as a measure of how good someone did over 6 months instead of as a measure of how good a player is right now, it makes a ton more sense. If you want a ranking that's explicitly trying to figure out who the best is right now, then you could look at statsmash.io, which has Quick at an impressive 39th. And that's another tricky part of this question. Is Europe underrated? Depends on who you ask. Now, the argument in favor of Europe is that the region lacks PGR players and well-known competition, so it's got more depth than people think. Sure, Quick and Space aren't top 10. They're probably not top 20 either. But they could be in that top 30 to 50 range, and they could be fighting and beating a lot of players who are as good as Ron or Bestness or Riddles or Big D. It's just that we don't know it because we don't see players like Big D or Riddles traveling to Europe. Hell, Ron barely travels in Japan. Only the top players travel to Europe, and they beat most players outside the top 10 anyways. Unfortunately, we just can't prove or disprove this argument without either bringing more 50 to 30 ranked players to Europe, or bringing more of Europe's top 10 to Japan and the US. And that costs money. And you know what the competitive Smash scene doesn't have a lot of? Money. The answer is money. So is Europe underrated? No one actually knows. It's hard enough to measure depth when you're looking at one country. It's really hard when you're looking at the whole world. A lot of people are really quick to hype up Europe, and we get that. If you don't look at the data or try and list out the top 50 yourself, it's pretty easy to get swept up in the Europe hype. And even after you look at the data, it's fair to think the Europeans are underrated because we just can't prove that they aren't. And because Quick Samus is nasty. If you're looking to make your region proud and up your level, be sure to check out ProGuides.com.